Somewhere on the seafloor of Papua New Guinea is the final resting place of 35 Allied submariners and one of Australia's greatest unsolved maritime mysteries, the disappearance of HMAS AE1. To find her, we formed a not-for-profit organisation called Find AE1 Limited. As a project team and board, we've done similar things before. We successfully managed to protect, preserve, and tell the story of HMAS AE2, lost during the Gallipoli campaign in 1915. She was the sister ship to HMAS AE1. But what do we know about AE1? We know that AE1 was at sea on the 14th of September 1914, in the first campaign by Australian forces in World War I. They'd been sent to hunt for German warships, seize German territory, and capture a wireless station near Rabaul. We know AE1 was with the destroyer HMAS Parramatta, guarding against a possible counterattack by the Germans. We know that she and Parramatta were within sight of one another at 2:30 p.m. off the Duke of York Islands. But by 3:20, Parramatta had lost sight of AE1. She has never been seen again. What has happened since? Wartime pressures cut short the immediate search efforts, and for over 60 years, AE1 and her crew were largely forgotten. Then, in the 1970s, the first expeditions to find AE1 were mounted by retired Navy Commander John Foster. He searched for 30 years. In 1990, underwater adventurer Jacques Cousteau performed a magnetometer survey of the area. The Royal Australian Navy has mounted several searches, the most recent a sonar search by HMAS Yarra during the 2014 centenary of AE1's disappearance. None was successful. This is where we come in. At Find AE1 Limited, the research of our team of submariners, historians, and search experts has led us to believe that AE1 diverted to the Duke of York Islands in search of a German steamer. We think she was lost after damaging her hull on one of the many reefs in the area. We've now identified a primary search area between the Duke of York Islands, Rabaul, and the fleet anchorage at Kokopo. In November 2015, we used sponsorship to fund a multi-beam echo sounder survey to test the theory that AE1 sank soon after striking a reef on the fringes of Miyoko Island. This high-precision survey combed the shallowest third of the primary search area. What did we learn? We found no wreckage. We now know that AE1 did not sink in the immediate coastal area. She must have commenced her return to harbour. We're closing in. The next step is to search the deeper waters. For this, we require specialised technology, a towed side-scan sonar and magnetometer. This is where you come in. From sponsors like you, we are seeking $1.7 million to fund a 30-day search. We still have two-thirds of the primary search area to cover. Locating Australia's first submarine, which was lost on active duty, will help resolve the circumstances of her disappearance, bring closure to the descendants, and do justice to the memory of her brave crew. Lest we forget.